What's up, everyone? Michael Ruddle, immigration attorney, here with another video for you on the many ways immigration impacts our daily lives. And so in today's case, the moment has arrived. You've probably been waiting at least 1 year to bring your immigration case to this point, and now it's time for your interview with USCIS. And so today I'm gonna give you a quick rundown of how to prepare for that big day and try to help alleviate some of the stress you may be facing. We're gonna cover what to expect, what to bring with you, and what happens after. To be clear, we're talking about a process called adjustment of status, where the applicant is applying for a green card based on marriage to a US citizen. So make sure your spouse goes with you on the day of the interview. That's very important. If you've already been waiting for several months and you've gone through the other steps of this adjustment of status process, then you know that USCIS is gonna send you an official notice to the address you have on file. You've probably received other notices already. An interview notice usually comes 2 to 5 weeks before and tells you the scheduled date, time, and location of the interview. Before we get into the types of questions you're going to be asked, let's talk about how to get through the day just from a procedural standpoint. First, obviously you need to know where to go. The interview notice will have the exact address and list the office in the building where you need to attend. So make sure you check something like Google Maps ahead of time to plan accordingly for the commute, traffic, parking, and of course, walking to the building to wait in line for security. There tend to be longer lines earlier in the day. The security at USCIS buildings is similar to what you might see in an airport. Plan to remove your shoes, jacket, empty your pockets, etc. No weapons, no drugs. After going through security, you will eventually make your way to the main room in the building where your notice tells you to go. Sometimes it's on a different floor. If you need help, the security guards at the main entrance are usually quite helpful in telling you where you need to go. Once you get where you need to go, you check in by presenting your notice to the person at the window, and then you wait. You hurry up and wait. The waiting is the worst part sometimes, because sometimes you only wait a few minutes, other times you can wait up to 2 hours. It totally depends on the officer and the volume of cases that day. They might be backed up. Once I waited 5 hours, that was a total anomaly, hasn't happened since. But my point is that earlier scheduled appointments tend to wait less than appointments scheduled later in the day. When you're done waiting, an officer will come out and call the name of the person who is applying for the green card. They won't say the name of the spouse. You'll be taken to an office with a desk and some chairs. Everyone will pull out a valid ID, and you'll all be placed under oath to tell the truth throughout the duration of the interview. Now that the interview is going to begin, we can get into the questions you can expect to be asked. In sum, the interview is meant to cover 3 separate topics, and they can be covered in any order depending on the officer conducting the interview. They are the applicant's most recent legal entry, proof of a bona fide marriage, and questions regarding admissibility. More on admissibility in a moment. As for your legal entry, you need to bring with you to the interview the original passport you used to enter, even if it's expired, because usually it will show the entry stamp that was given in your passport when you arrived. Also bring a copy of your I-94, which is also additional proof that you entered the United States legally. So you can expect questions to this issue on when was your last entry? Where did you last enter? What type of visa did you use to enter? Most of this information can be found on your I-94 or in your passport stamp. As far as a bona fide marriage is concerned, what exactly does that mean? Well, in immigration terms, a bona fide marriage means that you did not get married for the sole purpose of getting a green card. Getting a green card might be one reason, but it can't be the only reason you get married. So expect questions like, are you getting married just to get a green card? When did you meet your spouse? Where did you meet your spouse? How did you meet your spouse? How did your relationship evolve from that first meeting into a relationship? How long did you date before you got married? Who proposed? Was there a ring when you proposed? When did you get married? Was there a big wedding? Do you live together now? Do you have plans for the future? What documentation did you bring with you today to show that you have a bona fide marriage? This is where documentation is very important. The interview notice sent to you by USCIS will list some things for this requirement in terms of documentation to bring. Some of it might not apply to you, some of it you may have submitted it already, but think of it in terms of things to show that you're truly married, right? You live together, you have kids, you have bank accounts in both names, you pay taxes together, joint health insurance, car registration, traveling to see family, plans for the future like a will or life insurance. This is not an exhaustive list by any means, and many, many other things can be included. The third portion of the interview will cover admissibility. Think of admissibility as reasons why the government can deny your green card even though you have a bona fide marriage and even though you entered legally the last time. These cover crimes, health issues, immigration history, economic stability, and security issues. The questions are listed throughout the form I-485 and are a series of yes or no questions. We don't have time to go through all of those yes or no questions today, but just know that most officers will not ask you every single question on the form, but some will. If that's the case, the interview will likely be over an hour long instead of the typical 20 to 30 minutes. Once the interview is over, you're going to be given a piece of paper, either requesting more documents or you'll be approved. Some final things to keep in mind: cell phone reception usually sucks, so bring something to read. Dress accordingly. I tell people business casual, no tank tops, no jeans, no sandals. You want to make a good impression. And get a good night's sleep the night before. That's all the time we have for today. Remember, you've come this far and the interview is just another step in the ultimate green card process. And with any luck, it will likely be the last step. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, hit that like button, click that bell, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already, and follow us on Facebook to stay up to date on the ways U.S. immigration affects everyone. Until next time, I'm attorney Michael Ruddle. Keep climbing that mountain.